In this section, we will understand various options trading strategies based on the greets. The first strategy which we will discuss is the option arbitrage strategy, which is based on put-call parity. The put-call parity is given by the following equation. As we know, if this equality is violated, there is an arbitrage opportunity. Let us understand this arbitrage strategy through an example. Suppose a stock ABC is trading at 90 rupees. Now, let us construct two portfolios, A and B. In portfolio A, we buy two things, a call option and a zero coupon bond. In put call parity equation, the left hand side represents portfolio A. We buy the call option on the stock ABC with a strike price of 100 rupee, priced at 8 rupees, and a zero coupon bond trading at 88 rupees and 56 paise, which will be worth 100 rupees at the option expiry time. In portfolio B, we again buy two things, a put option and a stock. The right hand side of the put call parity equation is portfolio B. We buy the put option with the same underlying and strike price as the call option, but priced at 12 rupees. Let us calculate the net worth of our portfolios. The worth of the portfolio A, which consists of the call option and the bond, is. Similarly, the worth of the portfolio B, which consists of the put option and the stock, is. Here, you can see that the value of portfolio A is cheaper than the value of portfolio B. So there is an opportunity for arbitrage, and we can profit from the discrepancy in the price of the two portfolios, which essentially should have been equal. We buy the cheaper portfolio and sell the expensive one to make a risk-free profit of 5 rupees and 44 paise, that is 102 rupees minus 96 rupees and 56 paise. Now we will discuss how different scenarios at the time of options expiry will affect this strategy. In the scenario 1. Suppose the stock price drops to zero at expiration. The call option that we had bought in portfolio A expires worthless, and the put option which we had sold in portfolio B is now worth 100 rupees. The put buyer exercises the option, and we have to pay 100 rupees to him. But we have the 100 rupee bond, which we can use to pay the put option buyer. Thus our net profit remains the same at 5 rupees and 44 paise. In the scenario 2. Assume that the stock price reaches 200 rupees at expiration. The call option is in the money, which is worth 100 rupees, and we have a bond which is also worth 100 rupees. The put option expires worthless, but we had sold the stock in portfolio B, which now costs us 200 rupees. So to cover the short position of 200 rupees, we can use 100 rupees from the call option and 100 rupees from the bond, so that our profit still remains the same at 5 rupees and 44 paise. The conclusion is that no matter what the stock price is, we will be able to cover all the positions and make a profit of 5 rupees and 44 paise. In a nutshell, we buy the portfolio which is cheaper and sell the expensive one and make a profit of the difference between the prices of both the portfolios. That's all for this video lecture. In the next video, we will understand box trading strategy.